Before I introduce our next speaker, allow me to say that the TTFA, under the leadership of President Raymond Tinky, sees the importance of these changes going a long way in bringing this country's football governance in line with other major organizations around the world that have adopted and continue to adopt best practice governance principles. Of course, we understand, we all agree that this is an ongoing process, and this commission will continue to work towards ensuring that local football maintains its position at the top of the chart, and is in fact a key participation among option, is a key participation option for all our stakeholders, our members, our participants, and of course our players. On that note, to tell us a little more about this entire process, I now call to the podium Mr. Primo Corvaro, Head of Member Associations for FIFA.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everybody. We are very pleased, and when I say we, my colleague from FIFA, but also my colleague from CONCACAF, we are very pleased to be here to work on the revision of the Constitution. FIFA was informed a few months ago by TTFA that they wanted to undertake this exercise of the reform, institutional reform panel, independent, to have a look at the Constitution and to come with a proposal. FIFA was very pleased with the initiative because it has brought, of course, good ideas, and I want to take the opportunity to commend the job which was done by the panel, and also the quality of the discussion we had yesterday and today. Sometimes a bit intense, yes, of course, but it's also the proof that we have interlocutors in front of us and with skills and competence. So I would like really to thank you and also the TTFA about the exercise which was done through this panel. This analysis is also going along with what FIFA is promoting in its member association. Until last year, there was in the FIFA statutes, there was a provision stating that the member association should adopt statutes or constitution according to the FIFA standard statutes. In May 2013, last year, there was an amendment of the FIFA statutes, and now it has become compulsory for all member associations to adopt statutes in conformity with the standard statutes. So what it is done here, it's an exercise that is taking place all over the world. It's not specific to Trinidad and Tobago. It's, as I said, taking place in many other places in the world. Now, we knew that elections were supposed to take place in November, so next month, and then, of course, we had also been informed of the outcome of the work which was done by the panel, and then we were faced with what to do. Shall we go to election with the current constitution, because it's November, or shall we think of something different, because you can imagine having an election according to the current constitution, and then in 6 months' time you have a new constitution, and then you have discrepancies with people elected according to a former, old, old-fashioned constitution, and then they will have to work with a new constitution. So the case was debated at the association committee, FIFA association committee, in September, and this committee is made of president of member association. There are 18, not always all present, but 18, so it's a high-profile committee, and the committee was briefed on the situation in Trinidad and Tobago, and then they decided, the member decided that TTFA should undertake the revision of the constitution first, and then organize election accordingly, and FIFA set a deadline the end of June next year. So by the end of June next year, the process should be completed. So of course it means an extension of mandate, which is not so natural, but we thought that it would be in the benefit of the TTFA. So that's why we are here since yesterday, and we will stay until tomorrow. We have worked very very intensively with since yesterday. And what the outcome of the revision process, it's really TTFA will be proposed to have a big change. There will be big changes compared to today's constitution. I give you an example. FIFA is trying to promote, when it comes to the composition of the General Assembly, the Congress, the representative of the football stakeholders, the football family, we try to promote a balance between what we call the elite football, first division, professional, whatever. Here it's the Pro League, it's the Super League. I saw many names, Super League. We consider them as being the elite football, and they deserve a say in the AGM, in the general meeting, in the Congress, which was not the case today. Today you have 44 delegates. Out of these 44 delegates, 40 are coming from the zones. Six zones, five delegates, and then it means 40. Then you have four additional delegates, I think it's coaches, referee, and few others. There is no presence of the elite football. There is no presence of clubs. And we understood very clearly from the panel that people were crying, clubs were crying to be represented at the general meeting, at the Congress. And this is, most of the recommendation of the panel fit with what FIFA is promoting. And here we were together by agreeing to open the door to the clubs. Now, we won't disclose, because we are still discussing, it's an ongoing discussion, but the principle, it has been agreed that clubs would be represented. So the elite football we have is shared. Then we have the amateur football represented by the zone, and then you have the group of interest. And you should have a balance within these three groups in order to avoid that one group prevail on the others. It's a kind of promotion of democracy. This is one example. There are a few other things that will be new to TTFA, and it corresponds to also, I would say, the latest trend that football family has witnessed, and especially FIFA. You know that FIFA has been criticized a lot because of ethics issues, and then we learned out of it that now FIFA has an ethics committee with people elected by the Congress, and now we are promoting ethics committee in all member association. Big impact. Again, it's a big impact. So today you didn't have this tool, so difficult to deal with this kind of case, and this is why FIFA was criticized. Things were happening, and you can't avoid that. President Blatter says often, I mean, the football is representative of the society. And in the society, you have good people and bad people. You can't avoid that in football. But what we must make sure is that we have the tools to correct what is wrong. And we didn't have that. So we learned by experience, and now within FIFA, we have this kind of mechanism, and we try to promote them in the member association. Electoral committee. Another issue, another subject, another topic. It's important. You know that elections are one of the main moment events in the history of football association, and a lot of tension. And if you leave the process in the hands of the TTFA or the national association, you might face problems. As you know, you can win election. You have two ways to win election. Either you gain the support of the majority, or you run alone. And to run alone, you just have to disqualify the other people. And it happened very often, this kind of situation, and then it's a denial of justice, is not correct, it's bad governance. So now with an electoral committee made of people elected by the Congress, not nominated or appointed by the executive committee, then you have an independent body in charge of organizing the election. If they take a decision with regard to a candidate, it is a body made of independent people elected. The National Association is not guilty of anything. So those are the new things that we are bringing into the TTFA Constitution. Some are corresponding to what the panel said. There are some suggestions that the panel also proposed that we couldn't accommodate, because FIFA is promoting principles. You can't go beyond these principles, but of course we take into account the specificities of each association. And here, for example, in Trinidad and Tobago, women football is important. Tomorrow you will have a semi-final. They are getting very good results. You have competition, you have women team. Of course, you can still develop. I remember yesterday we met someone, a member of the Exco from Tobago, say, well, we have only four teams, female teams there, but we are improving. But there is a presence, obvious presence of women football in Trinidad and Tobago, so they will be also accommodated in the TTFA. In other countries, you don't have football, women football, of course you won't do it. So this is what I want to say, is that we take into account the specificities of Trinidad and Tobago, and we hope and we are confident that by tomorrow, or let's say the next day, we will finalize a document that will be acceptable to FIFA, and that will be the results of a long process made with very competent people. We just came here to fine-tune or to guide a bit, but the most of the work was done by the panel and the TTFA. So we are confident that we will come out with a very good document. Of course, then after, it will be the challenge of to adopt the statutes, because it is important to understand that the current the new constitution will be adopted by the current delegates, meaning the 44 delegates will have to accept the changes. But we are sure, we are convinced by the quality of the people who have been involved, the fact that FIFA is behind, people will accept, will understand that it is for the benefit of the TTFA. Once we will have adopted the statutes, the constitution at the TTFA level, then you will have to work at the membership level also, as well. Each member, let's say if you have clubs, if tomorrow we decide that clubs will belong to the TTFA as full member, they will need to have their own constitution. The same for the group of interest, the same for the zones. And that's another challenge, because they must be properly constituted before the election. The day of the election, we want people, delegates, who have been elected in presence of electoral commission, it's not decided yet, but most probably, according to a constitution which is in conformity with the TTFA constitution, which itself is in conformity with the FIFA statutes. And then in this constitution of the members, you will have the mechanism of on how to designate the delegates that will come to the Congress for the election of the next leadership of the TTFA. The day of the election, we will have, I don't know how many delegates, but they will have been properly elected, no dispute, and representing in a balanced manner the main stakeholders of football here in Trinidad and Tobago. So again, I would like to thank you, all of you. I will not quote each of you, but thank you very much. And I'm looking forward for the next hours, intense discussion, I'm sure, but productive discussion, I'm convinced. Thank you again.
Thank you so much for your remarks, Mr. Corvaro. Certainly there are no quick fixes here, but the association firmly believes that improving the process, constitutional reform and constitutional assistance is critical towards the way forward for football in Trinidad and Tobago. The panel obviously has to get back to work, which means that we have a very short window for question and answers for those at the head table here. And if you can just identify who your question is directed at, and then we can start the process. Any opening questions? Mr. Pouche.
Mr. Timke, Mr. Corvaro?
Primo.
Mr. Primo, yeah, that's easier. Said that the constitution will have to come back to the clubs, the delegates, sorry, to get approval. What happens if the clubs don't want what is being proposed?
Well, there must be some reasons, and we'll try to see how best we could treat those reasons, but or some persuasion has to go on. Something has to happen, because what we have now just not cutting it. And some of these experiences we have had over the years came to the fore simply because of how things were constructed. And if you want to get different results by doing the same thing, well, then you're bordering on insanity. We have to change it. And we have to do some persuasion, some talking, some education, something.
And one more question. Do you know at this moment if the majority of the clubs, the delegates, support this independent review commission and the work that is undertaken? Because that would be important in terms of consensus going forward.
Well, up to last evening, there was a meeting among the executive members, and they have all undertaken to support the initiative, the final document, of course, which we are working on now. So that when the time comes, when it returns from FIFA, we expect to get some affirmative action there.